Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Today we are going to look into the unboxing and full specifications of Redmi Note 10 series. They have launched it today at 12 PM. It is a 4G mobile, but the specifications are better comparing to other mobiles at this price range. Before going into the video, whosoever is new to the channel, kindly subscribe it and click on the bell icon so that you guys will never miss any latest updates. Kindly watch till end of the video so you will get the complete information about these mobiles. Let's get into the video. Let's talk about the design. All the three mobiles comes with evolved design, and Redmi Note 10 Pro and Pro Max will come with three premium colors: vintage bronze, glacial blue, and dark night. Redmi Note has three different colors, and it has aqua green, frost white, and shadow black. All the three mobiles has frosted glass back finish and anti-fingerprint and non-slippery texture. Now let's see about the camera features of these three mobiles. Redmi Note 10 Pro Max and Redmi Note 10 Pro has a main difference in their main camera. Redmi Note 10 Pro Max comes with 108 megapixel main camera, and the Redmi Note 10 Pro comes with 64 megapixel camera. And the rest of the cameras like macro lens and ultra wide and depth sensor are same for both mobiles. Macro lens, they have used around 5 megapixel super macro lens, and they used 8 megapixel of ultra wide lens and 2 megapixel of depth sensor camera. If we talk about Redmi Note 10, the main camera comes with 48 megapixel Sony IMX582, and they used 8 megapixel of ultra wide lens and 2 megapixel of macro lens and 2 megapixel of depth sensor camera. If we talk about front camera, both 10 Pro Max and 10 Pro comes with 2.96mm punch hole with 16 megapixel, and Redmi Note 10 comes with 3.54mm in display punch hole with 13 megapixel. Now let's talk about the display. Redmi Note 10 Pro Max and Redmi Note 10 Pro comes with 6.67 inch Super AMOLED display with Full HD Plus and 120Hz refresh rate, and it also has side mounted fingerprint sensor. And if we see about Redmi Note 10, it comes with 6.43 Super AMOLED display Full HD Plus with 60Hz refresh rate, and it also contains side mounted fingerprint sensor. As it is a Super AMOLED display, so they would have given an in-display fingerprint sensor so that it would be a better option. Now let's talk about the performance. Redmi Note 10 Pro Max and Redmi Note 10 Pro comes with Qualcomm Snapdragon 732G with 8 nanometer process technology with Adreno 618 as its GPU. It has Elite gaming features with dual layer graphite coding. Now let's see about Redmi Note 10. It comes with Qualcomm Snapdragon 678 with Adreno 619 GPU with dual layer graphite cooling. And if we talk about these three mobiles, they weighs around 192 grams with 8.1 mm thin. And it comes with dual stereo speakers which contains high resolution audio along with that 360 ambient light sensor. If we talk about this battery, both phones, Redmi Note 10 Pro Max and Redmi Note 10 Pro, contains 5020 mAh battery with 33 watt fast charging. And the company is also providing inbox battery adapter. When it comes to Redmi Note 10, it comes with 5000 mAh battery with 33 watt fast charging. When it comes to OS, all the three mobiles comes with MIUI 12 with Android 11, and it also have an option to uninstall some of the system applications. Now let's talk about the pricing of these three mobiles. Redmi Note 10 Pro Max comes with three different variants. 6GB RAM, 64GB storage comes for ₹18,999. And 6GB RAM and 128GB storage comes for ₹19,999. And 8GB RAM and 128GB storage comes for ₹21,999. And in the next, we have Redmi Note 10 Pro. It also having three different variants. 6GB RAM and 64GB storage comes for ₹15,999. And 6GB RAM and 128GB storage comes for ₹16,999, and 8GB RAM 128GB storage come for ₹18,999. And last in the list, we have Redmi Note 10. It also comes with two different variants. 4GB RAM and 64GB storage comes for ₹11,999, and 6GB RAM and 128GB storage is available at ₹13,999. My opinion for this mobile is that it could be a 5G version in the maximum variant. If anyone want to use this mobile for 3 to 4 years, this is not a best option. Why? Because by later this year, we could see 5G in India.
So many cannot afford for the upgradation within an year or two. So it would be better if they think a bit. And I suggest these mobiles to the one who are ready to use only for 2 years. I really suggest to buy this mobile. As per the yesterday spectrum auction, only 4G spectrum auction has been held. To get 5G, it may take another 2 years. All the similar smartphone with 120Hz refresh rate and AMOLED display are more than 25,000 rupees. So this could be the one of the best smartphones to purchase at this price range. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe and follow DigiIntegrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. And don't forget to click on the bell icon.